In this tutorial, we're going to work on making a sewer grate using arrays. To get started, let's open a sketch on the front plane. Now, most sewer grates are typical rectangular objects, and we'll just go ahead and do this. I want to introduce to you motions to get commands. It's a new thing in SolidWorks 2010. If you hold down the right mouse button and then move or drag, you can see that this opens up a context tool. And what this is doing is it automatically selects a new command for you. So in this case, I've customized mine to have the dimension, open a new sketch, fillet, rectangle, and extrude cut. So if I do that, it opens a command. What I'm going to want to do is I actually want to dimension this. So I'm going to open up Smart Dimension. I'll make my sewer grate 24 inches square. And I'm going to do that by just putting one dimension on there, and then using relations, I can select that side and then select the bottom side and say that I want them to be equal. And this will make sure that now I just have one dimension that controls the size of my sewer plate. Right clicking and dragging again, I'm going to go ahead and extrude that shape, and I'll extrude it up 1 inch. These guys are pretty thick, solid steel. And so now I have a pretty basic sewer grate here. So I need to go ahead and put some holes in it. I'll start by putting, opening up a new sketch and putting the mounting holes in it, which are going to go in the corner. And I'll smart dimension these guys to be 3/4 of an inch. And they are going to be just 1 inch from each corner. Then I'm going to use put center lines on the part. So if I click on the down arrow, I can get a center line tool. And you'll notice as I mouse over the midpoint of a line, it gets highlighted. And once it's highlighted, I can drag down another line. And I'll do the same thing horizontally to get these center lines. And center lines are just used for construction. And then I can go ahead and mirror. And I'm going to mirror my circle. And I'll mirror it first about this horizontal axis. You'll notice the mouse shows up with a green check mark. If I right click, I accept that, and it mirrors that across. And I'm going to mirror it again, and this time I can select both circles and then the checkbox. Oops. And then I need to, I don't want to mirror the line, but I want to mirror about the line, so I make sure that in my feature manager on the left, or the property manager, I select this horizontal line and click check, and it's okay. Again, the mirror entities is in the sketch toolbar, and it will mirror sketch entities across lines. So I've got these four lines. I can use my handy dandy right click drag and do an extrude. And actually, I don't want to extrude these, I want to extrude cut them. And so I will do that. And let's see, feature, extrude cut. And I'm going to say through all. Okay. And so now you can see that I have the four mounting holes. And now I need to put some holes in this perforated plate. I'll do this first. I'm going to open up a sketch. And I can get perpendicular to the sketch. I'll draw a circle. I'm going to just make a pretty simple sewer grate here. And I'll dimension this circle. Let's make that circle, oh, maybe 2 inches seems like a good size to me. And we'll have this start 2 inches from the edge in each direction. That might be too close. We might need to update that. Yeah, let's make it 2.5 inches. Okay, now I can proceed by drawing a whole bunch of different holes here, but I'm just going to go ahead and cut this hole through the plate using the cut, and that'll be good. Okay. And now what I'm going to use is I'm going to use the linear pattern tool. Okay. The pattern tool makes a pattern of features that you want repeated. The first thing you have to specify is the direction you want the feature repeated in, and I'm going to say you select any line, and that will work, and then you say the distance that you want, and I'm going to have a spacing of 3 inches, so that'll put 1 inch in between each feature, and then you can see I'll rotate it a little bit so you can see this yellow line here. You can just toggle up, and I think that'll be good for my array there. Then I can actually do two directions at once, so I can also select this direction, and I want my spacing in that direction to also be 3 inches. And it will make an array of these guys, so I'm gonna go ahead and fill this out. And maybe let's make our spacing, let's do 2.5 inches instead in each direction. Okay, and I can add a few more holes this way. Maybe 8 looks good there. Okay. If I go ahead and check, it repeats that command over and over. So rather than having to draw each of those circles, I can just copy them and repeat them multiple times. All right. In our next demo, we'll show how to do this so that these always stay centered using relations and equations.